Alright, this is a guide on how to record and edit your own league videos. It's a really simple process, but there are some things you can do to improve how well you can record and stuff like that. But first step, simple step, is go to leaguereplays.com and download their replay program. It's amazing. It's a third-party program that allows you to record all your matches and play them back. And you can record them in the new spectator mode. Well, it's not new anymore, but the spectator mode option, which lets you pretty much get all sorts of angles and shadows and do cool effects and stuff. It's really awesome, and it's free, so download that. Once you have that running, once you have that downloaded, run it. And go to settings. This is the important part. Okay, so your path, directory, stuff like that, you know, play around with that, see whatever you want. You just find where you have league, and then where you want to put the replays and data. Let's make a folder. Okay, with Fraps Fix, I don't have this running. It seems Fraps is buggy when it comes to watching in non-spectator mode. But with the new spectator mode, which I'll go more depth into soon, is like I don't use it. I don't need Fraps Fix. So I don't have that running. But you can see if you need it. You shouldn't. Prevent cursor clipping. This is important if you have two monitors. If you have this on, which I think is the default, it won't let you scroll to left, to the left side or right side, depending where your second monitor is. Like, it'll just, your mouse will move to your second monitor and disappear, and you won't be able to scroll to the left, so have that turned off. Record while spectating. This is really cool if you want to make a video out of maybe a friend's game or high elo games or something. It records any match that you spectate, and it'll record for the duration that you're in it. So if you join late, you know, you'll get the however long you were in it. But it's really cool. I don't have it running because I don't really spectate, but I recommend this if you watch a lot of games, you want to maybe make a video out of other people's games. Record all match spectator mode, run this. This is, you could do both, because the old spectator mode has, what's cool about it is it's kind of like a first person point of view where it shows what you saw when you're playing it, so it'll have your cooldowns and stuff. But generally spec mode is 100 times better because it lets you do a lot of cool things like view certain players, view certain team, fog, shadows, zoom in, like, you know, stuff like that. All my videos are in spec mode. You should really try that out. I recommend it. It's a bigger file size, but it's worth it. Sorry, Windows. This is really good if you plan on recording all your matches. You don't want to have to remember to turn log replay on every time you turn on your computer, because you might forget and you'll miss a game and you'll be really sad. Let's turn that on. The rest of that's whatever. Okay. So we have that. Now the second thing is to download Fraps, which is what you're going to use to record. Fraps is a free trial. You have to buy the full version or get the full version somehow. But free version is pretty much the same. I think, like, the only difference is, I think, it's a 30-second cap, which isn't a big deal if you're doing montages or whatever. But, you know, if you want the full version, definitely get it. It's an awesome program. But okay, install that and everything, and then here we go. Most important step here is when it says folder, you go to movies because you're recording movies. Oh, when you're FPS, I turn off hide overlay because it pretty much any time Fraps is on, it'll show like a FPS number up here, show how many frames you have, but I don't have that, I don't use that because I'm recording, I don't need to see what FPS I have. But for movies, folder save movies in, okay, this is really important. See, notice how it's my F drive? You want Fraps to record into a different hard drive than the one that your game's in. So if you're recording League of Legends, you have League installed on C and you're running it from C, then if you have Fraps, also record the C, it'll be really laggy. Like, I won't be able to even get, you know, 10 FPS. But if I have it saved to an external hard drive, like I do, I get, you know, really no lag, whatever. It's really awesome. So this is, like, the most important step. Really try it. Like, you'll notice a huge improvement in your FPS. At least I did. Hopefully it'll work for everyone else. I kind of just found that out. Figure out what FPS you can run at. What's good for you? Split movie? No, don't do that. record Windows 7 sound. Okay, that's just game sounds. That's important. External output, don't have this on. It'll record your mic. Like if you're doing commentary, you could use this. But if you're doing a montage, whatever, you don't want you hear yourself breathing, whatever, when you're recording. Hide cursor window. Turn this on if you're doing montage. I have it off because I'm recording this, but you don't want your cursor in game. It'll look weird when you're doing a video thing. Lock frame rate while recording. I don't use that. Force lossless RGB capture. That's just, it makes the colors really bright and nice, but it really hurts my FPS, so I can't run that. Or I just lag too much. Okay, that's the settings. That's what you need to do. And now, let's record a match. Okay, so now we're in the LoL replay. As you'll notice, it looks just like the spectator mode option. Or it's just like spectator mode when you try to watch a game. And this is because you turned on that spectator mode option in your LoL replay, which really gives you this nice thing. At the start of match, it'll take a bit for it to load before you can skip to. There you go. So you can skip through the whole game. So I can skip to 7 minutes. I can look around. I can speed up. Look for a play or something that I want to record. If you've ever, I'm sure most of you have used spectator mode before, so you know all these things. But I'll just go over them anyhow. So here, you get to take away what you want, like if you want to hide the mini map, or maybe you want to hide frames. Like when I record my montages, I hide everything, so you can really get you can really focus on the play and it's really clear. Scoreboard, you can take away that with tab. I won't go over the hotkeys, but there's a lot of hotkeys that you can learn. I don't have time to go over all those. Chat's kind of hard to turn on because you have to set it up here, and when you're recording and when you're playing the game, you have to show all chat, and eventually it'll work. It took me forever. Like most of my videos didn't have chat because I didn't know how to set it up, but I finally got it set up. So now you'll see when someone says something in all chat, like right there, and then you can. A lot of people don't know this. If you watch someone's video, you'll see like chat keep repeating because they go back and they're like, oh no, I want to record this again. So they see you get the lol. But if that happens, you can you can just simply press clear history, and you'll have it clear up. You don't have to restart the replay or whatever. So that's one little small trick. Let's go to the minimap again. The easiest way to quickly hide everything and record, which is what I record gameplay, just click H. You'll see you'll get just the hero, whatever. But you usually, if you want chat, you can't do that. You have to actually manually turn off everything except for chat, which is a pain. But you have to do that. Okay, now next step, next really thing that a lot of people ask me about, how do I want to replay? How do I get the camera to pan so smoothly like I am right now? This is a small trick that I came up with, and I'm actually kind of proud of this because it's awesome. You go to more options. Okay, you go to more options, and here you go to drag scroll speed. If you have this at max, see this? It just flies around. But also realize LoL replay is different from your league game, so you can fuck around with this and won't affect your it won't affect your game. So like I have drag scroll speed kind of high when I'm actually in game mode. When I'm recording, which is LoL replay, I have it really low, so I can do these kind of pans. And pretty much what you do, you press down your mouse button, mouse wheel. You just press it down and drag left or right. See how smoothly it pans? This is something that you'll see in my videos. That like I said, a lot of people ask, they're not sure how to do it, and that's that. Now, honestly, that's pretty much it. You know, you run fraps while you're doing this. Usually what I'll do is I'll go through and I'll try different, you know, zoom ins, pans, see if I want to, which way I want to scroll, if I want to do, these are the F keys, but you can, if I want to do, you know, from, you only see one team, maybe hide the fog of war, show it. I'll play around with that, and once I get that down, I'll go backwards, and then I'll press my record button, and I'll start recording, and I'll stop recording, and simple as that.